There are a couple of other quick updates on programs that I'd like to share with you before I go into the new initiatives that you will see this year. As you know, I announced a half marathon and a 5K race back in 07. Then after the loss of my son, Brooks, the committee named the race the Brooksie Way. Now the Brooksie Way is an extrapolation of a phrase my son-in-law used in his eulogy, live life the Brooksie Way. As many of you know, we teamed up with the good folks at the Krim Foundation, and we have now had three successful half marathons and 5K races in 08, 09, and 10, with expanding participation each year. Last year, there were more than 5,000 runners. And last year's State of the County address, I announced the expansion of the Brooksie Way races with the creation of the Brooksie Way Mini Grants, M-I-N-I. These are small financial grants with big results. Let me explain how they work. Any organization around Oakland County, which has as its mission, as not only its mission, but its core function, the improvement of the physical health and well-being of its membership, such as a senior dance club, swim clubs, 5K runs or walks at their local church, they can apply for a financial grant called the Brooksie Way Mini Grant to help fund their program, their health programs. These grants are funded from the proceeds of the Brooksie Way Half Marathon. Since the inception of the Brooksie Way Mini Grants, we have now given 35 grants, totaling nearly $37,000 to organizations who promote healthy and active lifestyles within their memberships. These mini grants are awarded to organizations that are struggling, obviously, in this economy. And there is one recipient organization in particular that I want you to see tonight. It's called Hugs for Horses, and this video says it all.
We are in Davisburg, Michigan at Pretty Pony Pastures, and we are doing therapeutic horseback riding with my special needs students.
Ready, Jess?
Okay. Most of my children cognitively fall into a range with an IQ under 70. Last spring, we were lucky to get, very fortunate to get a mini grant through Brooksie Way, and that's covering our riding for this session here in the fall. I really thought it was a shot in the dark when I applied for it, but we would not be riding this fall without it. You know, it's one of those things that's ongoing. I'm always looking for, you know, that next session to be covered.
You all can understand why this mini grant program is really catching on and is so successful. In 2006, we had a 20% spike in the cost of our health care for our employees.
20%.
An unanticipated 20% spike can wreak havoc with the budgeting process, and we knew that we had to get a handle on that. We were determined to tame the runaway cost of health care. And the end result of that commitment was a program that we launched in January of 07 that we call OakFit. The OakFit program is now 4 years old, and it is a multifaceted program that begins with a blood screening appointment where trained personnel check the glucose and the cholesterol levels. They do blood pressure and they do a BMI measurement. Then a second component, which is a risk assessment survey, combines the screening results with a risk survey to determine who are the high-risk employees. If we find any, they are referred immediately to their primary physician. In 2007, our outside consultants referred 15% of our participating employees onto their primary physician. 4 years later, only 4% were referred. So you can see what is happening. The high-risk employees are being identified, referred for treatment, and the potential development of costly chronic health conditions is being significantly reduced. Ultimately, it represents a substantial savings to the county through cost avoidance. We also have a plethora of lunchtime programs available for our workforce. Weight Watchers came on campus, yoga, Pilates. We have a lunch and learn series where lecturers are brought in to talk about health topics of interest. All employees were encouraged to go to the farmer's market with a $5 coupon, good for the purchase of only fruits and vegetables. A health fair was instituted, which has become very, very popular with our employees. And on it goes. The OakFit program has been an unqualified success, and our rising health care costs have been tamed. We call it bending the curve. The program has now drawn state and national attention. I had the pleasure of appearing on Fox News a couple of times, and here's the January 16 clip from Fox and Friends.
Good morning, Allison.
All right, so you were worried, naturally, in 2006 when the employees' health care costs jumped 20%. So you started this awareness campaign, and you spent $400,000 a year to do it. How did it work?
Well, it's worked very well. We have actually sort of bended the trend of increasing health care costs. Had we not gone forth with that program, our cost would be today $50 million for health care instead of $38 million. So we can show a huge saving for that investment.
Did I actually say bended? Oh, boy. Wordsmith. What you saw in that brief video is absolutely correct. At the end of 2010, we're paying the same rate for health care coverage for employees as we paid back in 2007. Now, using a simple projection of 9% increase, which is the normal average increase around the country, our cost would have been this year $50 million. But today, we're still at $38 million, and we're not done yet bending the curve. Other programs, such as smoking cessation and stress management, will also be introduced this year. My goal, ultimately, of course, is to improve the health and quality of life of my workforce. Do you folks see the mosaic that we're stitching here in Oakland County? Now we have the very successful OakFit program on our campus for employees. 8 years ago, we launched the Count Your Steps pedometer walking program for 34,000 third and fourth grade students, children, who are in our schools, to get them off the couch. In 07, we announced the Brooksie Way half marathon. Then there's the Oakland Edge, which is a hockey tournament coming up in a couple weeks. Most recently, the Brooksie Way mini grant program has been successful and launched, and it's really the octopus that puts its tentacles into all 61 communities within Oakland County with a long-range goal of improving the health of all of our Oakland County residents. I'd like to think that maybe 10 to 15 years from now, we will have increased in a quantifiable way the quality of life of the people in Oakland County and the quality of life that they enjoy living here. I would be terribly remiss if I didn't give credit where credit is due. The successful OakFit program is the brainchild of our human resource director, Nancy Scarlett. And Nancy, along with Dawn Hunt, who assumed the role of coordinator of that program, really nurtured this program from its humble beginning to the nationally recognized program that it is today. Nancy and Dawn, I want to thank you for a job well done. And ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to direct your attention to the screens where we can see the private sector partners who support OakFit. We really do have an ongoing romance with the private sector, and they step up and help this program reach the pinnacle of success that it has. The OakFit program is so successful that I am in active negotiations right now with Representative Gail Haynes from Oakland County, who happens to be the chairperson of the Health Policy Committee in the Michigan House of Representatives. As a chairperson of that important House Policy Committee, she sees some opportunities to take OakFit to Lansing and expand its positive cost savings impact statewide under a new moniker, maybe called MyFit. Now, no details are available yet, but we're flattered when the state might look at and adopt OakFit as a Michigan model. Thank you, Gail. Over the years, we have proven that we can reduce our utility costs significantly by adopting energy-efficient policies in the county. Really, folks, in these instances, it's like picking low-hanging fruit. For example, in 2005, we saved millions of taxpayers' dollars on our utility bills through simple steps such as changing our nighttime building lighting procedures on our campus to adding sensors to our sprinkling system. That's low-hanging fruit. Pursuing these efficiencies further, last May I announced the Oakgreen Challenge. I encouraged all of Oakland County residents, businesses, and governments to reduce their energy consumption by 10% by the end of 2012. In fact, I renew that call to all of you tonight to take part of the challenge. Go to our website for the details. It's oakgov.com/oakgreen. Oakland County government has already reached that 10% goal, so I gave my facilities management team, led by Director Art Holdsworth, an additional challenge of reducing the county's, Oakland County's energy consumption by 15% by 2015. Art's department has formed a green team under the direction of Facilities Maintenance and Operations Manager Bob Larkin, who is looking to identify ways to further reduce energy consumption across our campus. The Green Team has been so successful that they were recipients of a National Association of Counties Award in 2010 for their leading edge green ideas. In fact, through the Green Team's efforts, the executive office where my staff and I work has been cited as the first Oakland County government building to receive an Energy Star rating. That means my office building meets stringent energy efficiency standards that have been outlined by the Department of Energy.